A huge factory blaze has put emergency crews to the test at Tullamarine. There were fears for a nearby service station as the fire erupted, then concerns about a huge smoke plume and signs the building might collapse. TEN's Mark O'Brien joins us live now from the fire scene. And Mark, what's happening there now?
Well, the good news, Helen, is that things are quiet now, and that's in sharp contrast to the action we saw here earlier today. This fire was one of Melbourne's biggest for a while and did throw up quite a few challenges for the firefighters. Now, some of those firefighters remain on scene and will be keeping an eye on things as a search for a cause begins in earnest tomorrow. These images were captured as workers fled soon after the fire started. A single garden hose had no chance.
All of a sudden, it was just flames at the top. Within probably 2 or 3 minutes, the whole building was just on fire. So there was just flames everywhere.
Inside the building, which housed three separate factories, timber slats for blinds fueled the flames.
The heat was pretty strong, and then from there, we just took off.
The fire raced through the complex, smoke billowing into the sky and seen across the city.
Smoke started coming through the roof. And then we all ran out and we've seen the middle factory there was up in fire.
The fire brigade attacked hard, sending 15 units with 54 firefighters to stop the blaze from breaking loose in the industrial estate. The smoke posed no hazard to planes at nearby Melbourne Airport. But on the ground, there were fears for one neighbour, a petrol station.
They've done a great job to ensure that it wasn't affected.
Police shut down the area as workers in nearby factories watched the firemen tackle the flames. The owners of the building devastated.
I just got a call from the tenants. Yeah. There's a fire.
After a couple of hours, there were fears that the building would collapse. So the plan was simple. Pull the firefighters back for the sake of their safety.
The walls have moved appreciably. The safety of firefighters and first responders is paramount to me.
So they hit the fire from the air and a safe distance until eventually they got the upper hand. Now the job is to find out how the fire started as workers wonder about their future.
So no work for a few weeks.
Mark O'Brien, 10 News.